हेलो फ्रेंड्स, व्हेन वी गो टू परचेस ए फ्लैट एंड व्हेन वी फर्स्ट मीट बिल्डर्स एंड रियल एस्टेट एजेंट्स, वी कम टू नो अबाउट सम टर्मिनोलॉजीज लाइक कार्पेट एरिया, बिल्टअप एरिया, सुपर बिल्टअप एरिया, लोडिंग एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. एवरी बिल्डर कैलकुलेट्स एरिया ऑफ ए प्रॉपर्टी इन अ डिफरेंट वे. सो व्हाइल बाइंग प्रॉपर्टी देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्कनेक्ट बिटवीन व्हाट वी पे एंड व्हाट वी एक्चुअली गेट. If we see the complaints filed in consumer court, the maximum number of cases are against builders on the issue of cheating. However, the latest Real Estate Act, RERA, Real Estate Regulation and Development Act, passed by the central government in year 2016, has now made it mandatory to sell flats on the basis of carpet area only. Because this is an area where many people get cheated. So first we will start with carpet area. Carpet area, also known as net usable floor area, is the space where one can spread a carpet. According to RERA, a carpet area is a net usable floor area of an apartment which includes usable spaces like kitchen, toilet, bathroom and internal partition walls. Now this brings clarity which was not there before RERA was introduced. For your reference, this is the plan of 2BHK flat and this is the carpet area which is marked in green color. For better clarity, I am listing out the inclusions and exclusions in carpet area. Carpet area includes area covered by internal partition walls of apartment, all rooms in a flat, kitchen, toilet, bathroom, cupboard spaces, staircases within the property unit. And carpet area excludes area covered by the external walls, surface shafts, balcony, utility area, open terrace area, lift and lift lobby, staircase, veranda, flower bed, clubhouse. So while buying property, look at the carpet area and then make your decision, because that is the number that will give you an idea of the actual usable space. Now let us discuss about built-up area. Built-up area includes the carpet area, external walls, balconies and service shafts. Here I am showing the plan of 2BHK flat which you can compare. And you can refer this plan in which green color shows the carpet area and blue color is added for external walls, balcony and service shaft. It all comprises of built-up area. Built-up area excludes open terrace area, lift and lift lobby, staircase, clubhouse, swimming pool. Roughly, built-up area is approximately 10 to 15% more than carpet area. Now we will discuss about super built-up area. If you have already purchased a flat or a property, then you must be knowing about super built-up area. I will give you my personal example. In year 2015, when I was searching for a flat, I came across this complicated situation. There was a difference between the area of a flat which was constructed before 10 years and the area of a recently constructed flat. Option 1. The flat which was constructed before 10 years has the area of 800 square feet and its value was 60 lakh rupees. Its per square feet rate will be 60 lakh divided by 800 is equal to 7500 rupees per square feet. Option 2, a recently constructed flat that has the area of 1100 square feet and the price was 65 lakh rupees. Its per square feet rate will be 65 lakh divided by 1100 is equal to 5909 rupees per square feet. Here you will say that option 2 is better than option 1. Because the area is more and rate per square feet is less. But when you see these flats physically, then you will feel that the area of flat in option 1 looks bigger than option 2. The reason was, in option 1, 800 square feet is the built-up area and in option 2, 1100 square feet is the super built-up area. When I asked about these areas to a real estate agent, he told me about the loading factor. The loading on recently constructed flat was more. The difference between super built-up area and carpet area is called as loading. When builder constructs a building, he constructs common areas like clubhouse, lift lobby, staircases, etc., which will be used by all the people in a building. So while deciding the price of a flat, he adds the area of these common amenities in individual flats. This area is called as super built-up area. Super built-up area is the built-up area plus proportionate share of common areas such as lobbies, staircases, lift shafts, clubhouse, air ducts, pipe ducts or shafts and other covered common facilities. Super built-up area excludes open areas such as play areas, gardens, parks, driveways and roof terrace. Super built-up area is approximately 20 to 40% more than carpet area. After RERA, it has become mandatory to all the builders and developers to sell the flat on the basis of carpet area and not on the basis of super built up area. Before year 2016, the builders used to sell flats on the basis of super built up area. So builders were getting more money because of super built up area, and government was also getting the higher taxes in the form of stamp duty charges. But the pain of buyer was not limited to this. The buyer will be paying the maintenance charges for the lifetime on the basis of this built up or super built up area. Earlier, the carpet area on which the builder calculates the price of property was not defined. Every builder or developer had his own method of calculation of carpet area. Before RERA, the builders used to inflate carpet area, as a result of which the cost of property would also shoot up. However, now the method of calculation of carpet area has been clearly defined by RERA, and therefore developers would not be able to manipulate the calculation of carpet area in order to increase the prices. So friends, I have tried to explain the concept of carpet area, built up area, super built up area and loading factor in this video. If you found this video informative, don't forget to give it a like and share it with everyone you know.